All right. Well, welcome everybody to this webinar on how to skyrocket your AMD practice. Thank you all for coming. And without further ado, I am going to share the little bit of introduction to what AMDs do. And I'm going to introduce the subject of this revolutionary new treatment called Airway Facial Epigenetics. And some of the successful AMDs are going to introduce what they do as a new practice, and that's led to great success. And how your new patients are going to find you as an AMD in your community. All right. So here's a revolutionary root cause treatment that's based on how the mouth contributes to troubled health. Okay, so if you have top health, you may or may not have impaired mouth. But if you have impaired mouth, you definitely gonna have troubled health. This is such an interesting topic that I wrote 5 books about it. The through line is that your mouth, it drives your health. It's that simple. Okay, so this is Dr. Susan Kane, whose before and after photo here represents a simple summary of what Airway Facial Epigenetics is. She also got 40% improvement in her airway and better sleep, and therefore, and all the pain went away so that she can walk her dogs again. So all of this is accomplished without shots that the patients dread about going to the dentist, without surgery, without drugs, without braces, and you get better face and better health. So that's why it's called revolutionary practice. And then we have Dr. Jeff Yelle here, and his airway treatment coordinator, Britteny, who will share their practice stats after starting AMD training. So you will also have an opportunity to learn how to skyrocket your practice, not only based on their model, but based on a new idea that I'm going to show you shortly. Okay, so this is my first book, 6 Foot Tiger, 3 Foot Cage, as all of you know well. And you need to know the oral contribution to systemic problems, medical, dental, and mental, emotional, as well as systemic problems to the mouth problem, such as hypothyroidism right here. And if you don't, then you're gonna be limited to just drilling, filling teeth, and counting head scratcher problems. You wouldn't know what to do with it. So here is a case who was lucky enough to end up in a airway mouth doctor's office. And if you use conventional dentistry standards, gorgeous teeth, straight and white, what's there to complain about? And yet he is miserable. This is a he. I want you to notice these two white bullets here. Grinding and clenching in sleep and crowded lower front teeth despite braces during his teenage years. So why do teeth relapse? Why is he miserable despite having straight white teeth? All right, so to answer that question, you have to understand that what we see on the face is underlined by a structure called the maxilla. When the maxilla is wide, the airway is wide. When the maxilla is narrow, the airway is narrow. It's that simple. This is Dr. Dave Singh's work way back in 2010 and 2011. So we are 13 years out and we're finding some amazing results. That's why there are 5 books and 5 journal articles to talk about it. I'll just mention a few just so that you get a flavor what it's like. So impaired mouth, for those of you who are watching this for the first time, consists of some of these conditions in blue. They will lead to many medical conditions in black, including OSA, which some dentists think that they know how to manage. Well, anytime you see crowded lower front teeth, it's because the maxilla is too narrow, all right? Anytime the maxilla is too narrow, you're gonna have airway problems like we've shown in the previous slide here. Okay, so what if you have impaired mouth syndrome? Guarantee you're gonna have airway issues. That's gonna lead to bruxing, clenching, and one dental trouble after another. Those of you who are here tonight, when we get to the panel part discussion and sharing your experience, feel free to chime in on any of these, okay? So pain and fatigue, as well as dental troubles, mood problems are gonna show up. So here's a real life case. 61 years old, having this set of teeth. She's been going to her dentist, gotten the necessary work done, and yet she had low back pain for 50 years and choked airway. Definition of epigenetics, how environment and behavior affect how genes work, okay? So you can influence how genes express in every person by changing the behavior and environment. When I saw this, I said, well, let's turn genes on in the mouth and let's see what happens. So on the top left, pre-treatment, and you go counterclockwise to the top right, it's 10 months. No drugs, no shots, no drill, no surgery. And that's because we do our homework as AMDs, as you well know. And that's because we also use a bone building diet that consists of the best from the plant kingdom, green smoothies, and the best from the animal kingdom, bone broth. And some of you are familiar with this. What I love the best about this case, not only her improvement in appearance, but her lifelong nausea went from 10 to 1. And her gastroparesis, meaning burping like a sailor, also went from 10 to 1. All right, so even her very hot flash got better. All right, so the mouth participates in many, many systemic functions. When you get them right, the patient's gonna look better, they're gonna feel better, and we are starting to publish these cases in professional journals. And here's another case where she had lifelong pain and crooked teeth, and she managed it with Thai massage every week and chiropractics. And this is her neck. So here's what happens after treatment. Her neck straightened with the combination of the other work, and now she needs to go to the chiropractor much less, hardly at all, and she enjoys the Thai massage, but she doesn't depend on it anymore. So here's a deviated septum pre-treatment. Different case, different patient. In the interest of time, I'm not going to show the entire case. And look at what happened after treatment. I traced it out for you. The septal deviation practically straightened. What happened? We epigenetically regrew his maxilla as a 43-year-old adult. And his molars went from end-to-end occlusion to proper cusp tip to fossa relationship. And his septum straightened. Okay, so dental patients have medical problems. Medical patients have dental problems. It's about time we connect them. And that is through airway, through hormones, all right? And through posture, fascia. In fact, there isn't one part of body that is not connected to the other part. How are the patients who are looking for these solutions going to find you? This is where your branding as an AMD comes in. So this is a new personal 360 website, okay? It's not part of my office website. This is separate. This is like your own calling card. This is how your patients are gonna get to know you, and this is how they're gonna want to make an appointment with your office, right? So we have Saul Alcina here. Saul, raise your hand. Yeah, the one with a beautiful hat. So, one more case, and then we'll turn it over to our expert panelists with their experience. It works for ladies, it works for guys. Nature is very kind. As long as you have sound natural teeth, airway facial genetics will, epigenetics will work. Okay, so here's his wife, sleep partner, and this is her report.
Hi, I'm Shannon Martin. Yeah. I am the wife of one of Dr. Liao's patients.
Okay.
And over the last 9 months, or is it a year, he's been using Dr. Liao's process and program to straighten his teeth out and help him have better breathing, healthier life. So what I've noticed is that he is sleeping better. He's not waking up in the middle of night as the night is often.
Really? Okay.
He's not having, he used to flail a little in the sleep, which is not doing the waking me up, of course, which I don't like.
Okay, so you can tell that firsthand, right?
Yes. He's also had a better memory, which is really important because, nice. You know, we were in a company, and that is very noticeable to me. Otherwise, I mean, he's got a lot. He's not waking up and, like, coughing himself awake. Like, he's not choking. He's not snoring as much either, which is nice, too.
Wonderful. Well, thank you for sharing your experience with us.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Okay, so her husband improved 90% on all his baseline symptoms in 30 months. Okay, this is across medical, dental, mental, emotional fronts. No drugs, no shots, no drill, no surgery. This is why it's revolutionary, and we have physical evidence that the maxilla grew by 8 millimeters and 6 millimeters, front and back, all right? So it actually happens. And his airway grew 61% in airway volume. We published this in General American Sleep and Breathing Academy. So this is part of the breakthrough we are creating using this approach. So here's the last one that I'm going to show you. The only study that really matters in my mind as an AMD is this one. Pediatric OSA in non-obese children is a disorder of oral facial growth, right? Grow the jaws, you won't have any problems. It's that simple. But then the next question is, who is trained in oral facial growth? Not in dental school, we weren't taught, right? So this is my granddaughter at age 6 months. And she was just starting to drool here because two new teeth were just coming in. So this is her dad, Chef Franklin. Some of you know him. He's now teaching kitchen medicine at culinary medicine, I'm sorry, at Baylor. So I just want to make a point. This is nature's Mayo Munchie. And we gave it to her. And this is how she grew. And this is what she looked like at age 3. No appliance is needed. This is what the essence of epigenetics is. What factors influence gene expression? All right. Gene expression is influenced by two things, according to CDC, oral behavior, and oral environment. All right. So when the factors are right, genes will fully express themselves, and there will be no crowded teeth. And all of that can happen without a dentist ever getting into the kid's mouth and shoot and drill. All right. So with that, I'm just going to turn this over to, I have oodles and oodles of slides that you can see, okay? But what is important to me is that you understand that there's tremendous pathology that we see in the mouth that has not been connected to systemic health, and that many of these patients are looking for answers, all right? They want breakthrough solutions. And here is Denise.
Hello, this is Denise. I wanted to pop in and let you know about patients looking for AMDs on social media. I, on average, answer about 10 different questions on our posts, and I would say close to 20 a month in our messenger about patients looking for AMDs.
All right, that's what her on-the-job experience is, as if perfect timing. Here comes Dr. Susan Kane. This is what airway epigenetics can do. Pre-treatment, she had gorgeous veneers done, and yet she suffered, okay? Another case of gorgeous teeth, miserable owner. How miserable was she? Well, she had all of these pre-treatment, and every one of them in 15 months got better to the tune of 96%. Again, no shots, no drills, no surgery. And same set of teeth, better face, no diastema, no recession. And so, are you there, Dr. Susan? Pipe up, unmute yourself. We're done, so you can introduce yourself now.
Good job. All right. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh, okay, good. I'm in traffic, so that's why it was hard for me to get.
No problem, no problem. Thank you for coming.
Yeah, so I feel amazing. I feel 10 years younger, at least, since I started wearing my appliance, and all of my family and friends know it too, and that's why they've all asked me to make them appliances. But what's exciting to me was just the fact that I could only work 2 days a month at this, 2 days, and have a major source of additional income, probably over $100,000 a year, just doing 2 days a month. And that's with not even owning my own office. So I imagine it would be more if I did, but I go in as a specialist, an airway specialist, to a biological practice. And I just see airway patients. They refer me patients. I go in every other Tuesday and they're lined up to see me. They're prepped and we give them the book and I have a consultation. That's the first step. And it's a $200 consultation. From there, then we do records, but it's the records that I think we charge like $1,800 for records. And I consult with Dr. Liao on those patients. And then from there, I present the findings. And then the rest is, we charge about $9,000 or so, more or less, for treatments. So, so then they move forward with treatment 98% of the time, something like that. And there are more patients that I've had to turn away, mainly because their personalities or, things like that, their commitment level. But I would say that my success rate in treating them has been phenomenal. There's a couple of outlier cases, but Even on the outlier cases, they've gotten better.
Great.
So that's what's very been, you know, amazing track record. And they're telling their friends, their siblings, their friends want to come, their parent friends. And it's now, I'm the only one in the area doing this. And the orthodontists have gotten wind of it, the physical therapists, the chiropractors, and they're starting to hear the buzz. So it's been blossoming, you know, more and more and more. So
thank you. Thank you. So this is a list that Dr. Susan gave me probably toward the end of last year. It's been 6 months now, okay? And her rate of acceptance was 32 out of 33 cases started in year one. I don't think general dentistry ever get that kind of acceptance rate. And she gets to be choosy on who she does not want to see, okay? So that's really impressive. And so we'll come back later to share more. But now I want to introduce Dr. Jeff and Brittany, his airway treatment coordinator. So this was an old slide, but I want to just show that Dr. Jeff was incredibly visionary. He got his whole staff trained and appointed, at my recommendation, a airway treatment coordinator. So this is Brittany. This is Brittany and this is Dr. Jeff. So Dr. Jeff, tell us how it's been for you.
It's been quite the roller coaster. So, you know, I mean, just a little context, you know, I'm a biological dentist and I do all phases of dentistry, you know, I treat, you know, 4-year-olds in ortho airway all the way to all on X's with implants, you know, so I have a very busy, busy practice. And I have a lot of demands on me. And so getting into this, it was really revolutionary. And, you know, just so people know, I come from an area in Colorado where a lot of people do airway. You know, there's, you know, a bunch of airway groups, right? I don't think some people are doing it appropriately. A lot of guys are dabbling in it. Some guys do it well, some guys don't. So it's not like I'm the only one treating airway.
Right.
And so I think that needs to be complimented because we've had incredible success. Like, I mean, there's been times when I'm just like, I can't take on any more cases. I can't, you know, we just don't have the time. Brittany doesn't have the time. But I think what's been very crucial in my success being, you know, a general dentist and hopefully one day just as airway.
We're working on it.
We're working on it. We probably could do it. We probably could. We're getting close. You know, it's just training that staff. I know, speaking to people who may listen to this, it's always hard to kind of suck up that first cost of, you know, paying for your employees' time, paying for their hotel rooms, bringing them there, like the whole thing, like it's expensive. But, you know, for me, it was definitely the way to go. And I this wouldn't have been able to do that if I didn't have a staff and I didn't have, you know, the support of Brittany, who went through the AMD training with me, who sees all these patients and does a lion's share of the work. You know, like we have a meeting once a week now and discuss cases and she runs with it. So, you know, especially in a busy practice, if somebody's trying to figure out how to do this, you know, you got to bring a staff member. I think it's just quite essential. And, you know, yeah, these are, you know, old numbers. Gosh, we're probably making, you know, and within the last 6 months, maybe a couple hundred thousand off of airway.
Yeah.
And that's without you having to bend over a patient to make that production, right?
No, it's easy and it's enjoyable, you know?
Yeah.
Like you get the patients coming in and they're like, oh, I'm sleeping better. I'm dreaming, you know, like, or, you know.
Headaches are gone.
Yeah. migraines have significantly decreased, you know? You know, so it's enjoyable dentistry. It's not like, oh, we do these veneers. Oh, my crown's off. You know, oh, well, it hurts when I hit here. Oh, well, my, you know, is it, could it be a little whiter, you know?
Yeah. It's a different way to relate to patients, isn't it?
You spend 4 hours prepping this veneer case, and they're like, well, you know, this incisal angle's a little off, you know, like these patients, are like, I feel great, doc, you know, and you know, don't get me wrong. Some of them, you know, we have outlier cases where they're like, you know, hey, I'm not feeling great. And you do your comparison. So when you first came in, it's like, well, you were getting 3 migraines a month. How many migraines are you getting now? A one. It's like, oh, maybe, and maybe it's controlled with Advil, so it's okay. You know, it's like, I mean, come on, you know.
Right. Okay. Is this still true, Dr. Jeff? Since you have the mic now,
yeah.
Is it still true? By far the highest ROI you ever say implemented.
Yeah, definitely. For, you know, I mean, 18. You know, I mean, yeah. The tuition was. I think actually, you know, maybe those numbers might be a little off. You know, I don't know if the tuition was 18. It might have actually been a little less, honestly, because I signed up a few years ago and bringing the staff. Like maybe we're at 18.
Right.
Compared to.
Actually, it was lower at that time, but I padded a little bit so that the newer AMDs who are registering don't feel so bad. Okay.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's it was lower. No, yeah, it's definitely been, you know, I do a lot of complex dentistry. Implants. I do it all. And so this one has definitely been the biggest bang, for just your buck, and you know, just honestly, you know. Probably one of the more aspects is I don't get head scratchers anymore. You know, I don't get those cases where I'm like, you know, I really don't know what's going on here. I you know, and you're just like, you're scratching your head trying to figure out what's happening. You know, so these patients that come in and they have pain, it's like, you know, I know what's going on, and, you know, I can treat you, and maybe they're not open to it at that time, but it's like, I have a solution for you when you're ready. You know, let's sit down and have a consult with it, and, you know, let's see what we can do. You know,
I want to interject there, doc, because I see so many patients in the assistance chair, and they're coming to you as like a last resort. They've been to so many dentists. They're like, what is wrong? And you go in, you talk to them. And then the next thing I see is they're in my chair for airway intake. And then I see them 6 months later, and they are a brand new person. Nobody's addressed it.
So would you tell us how you make that happen? Like, Dr. Jeff, did you give Brittany her own chair, her own column on your schedule? How did you guys work this?
Yeah, so that's exactly what we did. Brittany has her own chair, her own column. You know, people come into her chair. You know, new patients now are coming into her chair just for, you know, our ortho airway intake. So, you know, we get people now that aren't even people in the practice that, you know, might go get their cleaning somewhere else. And, you know, they're coming to us for airway. So, yeah, she has a dedicated, you know, phone number, a dedicated, you know, chair. She sees those patients. And so that's been super helpful. Cause I don't know how you would do it without that. And, you know, we're in a competitive market. It's not like we're the only people doing airway here.
Right,
and we're
right.
still inundated where yeah. there's times where we're like, pause.
There's so much hunger out there for this solution, right?
Yeah, it is. And honestly, I'm underdiagnosing. You know, I would honestly admit, like, I could do more.
You could. You just need to find an associate first. I always tell all the AMDs in my class, right? First line out of my mouth is that you're going to need an associate. Is that
true? If somebody could do my implants and general dentistry, like, I could run this much more efficiently. But, you know, we're still definitely, I mean, it's still a very productive part of our practice. And, you know, and even all the staff that doesn't do airway appreciates the bonus that comes from airway.
You bet you.
The
boats.
The staff gets a little upset, though, because our patients are so appreciative. Only Dr. Jeff and I get, we get like presents for Christmas. I hide mine because I don't want anybody to get jealous.
Yeah. Okay. So, do you have some updated numbers for us, Brittany?
I think I sent them to you.
Oh, okay. You want me to pull them up?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll do that. I didn't know if you. Okay, sure. No problem. I can do that.
Thank you. Let me
see. I think I have it too. Sorry.
You do? Okay. Well,
I have them here.
Okay. So why don't you put that up and I will make it for you to share screen.
Okay. I don't know if I can share it on the screen. We'll see.
Go ahead.
So everybody,
just hold on 1 second, Jeff. Everybody, so let's all thank Dr. Jeff and Brittany for setting a shining example and their willingness to share these numbers with you and their success stories. Okay. This is how you skyrocket. This is how you your AMD training could bring. Okay, go ahead, Dr. Jeff.
Yeah, so in the last 18 months, just in intakes, which
you got your slides? You got your slides?
No, I don't. I have it.
Oh, you have it? All right, thanks, Brett.
All right, so put them up. You can share screen. And I want you to keep commenting once the slides come up. I use Keynote and you use PC, so the slide didn't drag and drop after you send it, Brittany.
Let me see. Give me 1 second. I never get on my app, my laptop. Okay, sure. Can everybody see that?
Yeah, I do.
Okay. AMD success, Dr. Jeffrey Yelle, the superstar.
There you go.
I don't know. Yeah, you're involved in that.
The superstar is not in the super production, okay? The superstar is in the leadership. All right.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, how you lead your practice to skyrocketing success.
So this was our total diagnostic records in 18 months was 53. The revenue generated was 44,000. But I put the disclaimer in there that the revenue generated also goes towards things. You'll see the mentorship fee, radiology fee, staff payroll. And the number of cases started in 18 months was 37, and total revenue was $235,217, which is awesome considering Dr. Yelle is running, you know, two columns of clinical, and no matter what, he always takes the time to like make Airway a priority as well.
That's what leadership means. Okay, I got it pulled up. We're sharing the screen now.
There we go.
Okay. So 18 months, 53 cases. Amazing, right? And so this is the revenue from just starting diagnostic records alone.
Yeah.
Yeah. For those people who are new to this thing, what does diagnostic records consist of?
So a diagnostic record consists of about an hour of Brittany's time, you know, taking photos, you know, just all the photos that you recommend. You know, honestly, we're probably not doing it as efficiently as we could. You know, there's definitely room for improvement.
It's okay.
You know, we could be doing the walk and other things. So there's always.
We just wanted to know the numbers.
So she took an hour in her time taking photos. Then, you know, typically we'll send off, we send off for the Sassoonian analysis. We do send off for a radiologist report. We could avoid that by doing getting our own cone beam images, but you know, it's just time in our office is at a premium. I would say at this point, you know, I send off probably about 70% of cases to Dr. Liao. You know, I've been doing this long enough where
you
like
know how to do it now. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, the easy ones I take in, I send you the hard ones.
I'm happy that you're starting to take off your training wheels.
Yeah, starting. I mean, starting. Still makes me a little
Yeah.
nervous, honestly.
But just tell, while we're on the subject, tell everyone how AMD mentoring has done for you.
It's been super essential. Honestly, I mean, you need mentoring during this. Like, there's no way of going about it. You gotta have somebody kind of looking over your shoulders because these are complex cases. These aren't simple. Even the simple ones. I mean, there's been ones where I think they're simple, and we get it in, and we talk to you, and we just say, yeah, you're not a candidate. So. I mean, I don't plan on discontinuing and not mentoring now for
Oh,
a while. Just I
this
learned
is
something on every case,
every one of you out there.
Oh,
This is user experience. You're hearing firsthand insights, okay?
yeah.
Yeah.
So, there's
Okay.
definitely every person's different.
Yeah.
And every case is, it's diet and lifestyle and, epigenetics, like, yeah, gosh, I mean, this starts at birth, and these are cranial deficiencies that progress through life, and correcting them later on in life gets harder than correcting them earlier in life. And, you need, and it just depends on, gosh, race, ethnicity, like, where do you come from? There's so many factors to this. So, if you think you're going to do this on just by yourself, gosh, it's going to take a while. I mean,
Thank you. Thank you.
yeah.
So Brittany, take us through the roughly two cases a month that you've done. How do you guys do it? I noticed that you sent me this desk. How do you get such success rate?
Dr. Jeff, Dr. Yelle, every new patient is screened for airway. And I think a
Wonderful.
lot of people are not used to being addressed for airway in new patient
Yeah.
intakes. And as soon as he starts the conversation, we're pacing back and forth through the room because we didn't allot for the time for him to talk about airway. But patients are so appreciative that he addresses it because they all have these underlying issues.
Yes.
So the patients end up in my chair. I mean, I talk to them a little bit, and I'm always like, let's see what Dr. Yell says. And then I just put together pretty much similar to this 4-slide PowerPoint, but it's 30 slides. And we sit down, we set aside time every week, and I say, what do you think? And then he goes through, he diagnoses, and then it's just the most amazing system that we have. I'm so appreciative of it because when
Wonderful.
I got hired there, I started off as an assistant, and
Yeah.
he said, I really want to get an airway department going. And I said, okay, I'll help you.
Yeah, there you go. That's leadership. And that's also a stroke of good fortune, right? That Dr. Jeff ended up with Brittany. He
Yeah,
says
and
yes.
I went to what was it? The first class, Dr. Jeff went without me, and then I went to the other four, and I just absorbed everything like a sponge. I took all of the education. It was so amazing. And I like to think that I maybe have a little bit of like say so, because I he'll see me pacing the hallways. He's like, what's wrong? He's like, what's
I
wrong
know
with
that
you?
feeling.
I'm like, this case is complicated. And aside from our meetings, he'll come in and he'll sit down. He was like, yeah, send it to Dr. Liao.
Yeah, well, actually, it's been a great deal of fun mentoring all the doctors who sent cases because these are the people who truly want to learn. And it's really like an in-office residency, right? You're learning without having to leave your office through your cases.
Exactly.
Very true. Yeah.
Okay, great. Anything else you want to add, Jeff or Dr. Jeff or Brittany?
No, I think that's it. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
I would like to say thank you. Sometimes when we're super stumped, you do jump on those late night Zoom calls because we're in mountain time. And
That's true.
you'll sit down with us. Even one, you had us with the patient one time, so
Yes,
we
yes,
just
yes.
appreciate, you
Oh,
being
you're
an
welcome. I
asshole.
mean,
That has been super helpful for especially those outlier cases. You know,
Yeah.
like we've got a couple outliers right now, and it's, I mean, and the cases are going well.
Yeah,
You
great.
know, and I would be, I guess, balder than I am if I didn't have somebody like, hey, I need to bounce this off. Yeah, you know, and you know, that's where community makes a big difference. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wonderful. Well, I want to thank you so much for being willing to share your experience. What's your parting advice for other tire kickers, people who are hesitating on the sidelines?
Oh, yeah, jump in and bring a staff member. That's
Bring a staff and jump in, right?
Jump in and bring a staff member. You know, it's gonna change the way you practice and it's gonna change everything. Yeah.
Brittany?
My dinner conversations have changed with my husband about dentistry.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, my husband is, I don't know, there's other people in this group, but it opens up such a conversation for him if he has troubled patients. And I'm like, what's their diet like? What do they have tongue ties? They need expansion and they won't have these issues. And I think it's just, I don't buy the same chicken anymore since I've been to your course.
Yes, I'm
And
so
Dr.,
proud of you. Yes.
I just think every dentist when, because I've lived through it, I've seen what my husband goes through. And the second that expansion is introduced into dental school, I think it'll change like a lot about dentistry. So I think the patients themselves and what I see them smiling more. They patients hug me like they're just so happy somebody, Dr. Yelle, finally addressed their problem and they found a solution to it. And it's so rewarding. It really
Yes,
is.
it really is. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So now, this is a great segue, right? How are those patients who need you going to find you? Right? I mean, what would you say the frequency or prevalence of impaired mouse is? It's almost 100%. Okay. And you deserve to be found. You deserve to be talked about in the nicest way. You deserve to go viral. And this lady here, so Alcina from Argentina, is the architect behind this branding campaign for AMDs. So I want to introduce you to so Alcina.
Hello, everyone. Wow, Susan Cain is in the house. And this is, love at first sight. I just cannot stop smiling. And I'm just very grateful to be here. But you will find out why love at first sight. I'm already in love with the purpose of, AMDs and all of you. But why love at first sight? Well, it's because it's really what sets your personal 360 sight. It sets you apart from, the typical, just boring office websites, as Dr. Felix actually was showing and telling during this webinar. You can actually search for Dr. Liao, Dr. Felix Liao.com, and you will see one of my disruptive designs because, showing the genuine of your personal values, right, and identity really drives the right matched patients, to you like moth to the light. I think we all been dating once, and CV it's not actually important in dating, but first impressions are. And I really care the way you present yourselves to people like me. I'm your target audience. My mom is your target audience. And we are looking for you. And sometimes we cannot find you. And websites that really reflect the personal identity can achieve, I will say, in statistics, not only me, as a branding expert, 90% engagement rate within the first 3 seconds, demonstrating actually the power of an unforgettable design. You know, this approach actually can really enhance patient engagement, like myself, and loyalty. I just, you know, hear once from one of the best marketing gurus that I know, Simon Sinek, that people will buy your why you do what you do, right? So if you want to increase patient engagement by 90%, if you want to increase 70% of your inquiries, I don't know about that, Jeff, and these successful AMDs today here on the room, but then brand yourself with disruptive and bold design, right? Because AMDs like you, that you are just one of a kind healer in your community, and I'm looking for you guys, you really offer this exceptional solution that we're all wanting, right? And as you have seen in this webinar, I mean, I'm impressed and amazed. That's why I'm choosing you to help, really, because you deserve to be noticed, you deserve to be celebrated. And again, people do not buy what you do, they buy why you do what you do. So that's why personal branding comes first, and that's why branding matters, because people are really not looking for just services, but they're looking to connect with values and identity first and getting to know, you know, the right place to go, right? So if you have a personal brand, then the right patients will be looking for you and for that best face and to relaunch their vitality with what you do. So as one of my best and favorite gurus said as well, Seth Godin, you know, market is no longer what you offer, right? Always, or the stuff you make or what you do, but it's about the story that you tell. And, you know, everyone is actually looking for the right healer. And I know this, you know, from my personal story and from a personal experience with my family, my mom and my niece Simona. So that's why I'm here to help you. And I choose to, as a branding expert, to make you shine. So, you know, let's tell your story to that audience and to the patients that are wanting to buy from you. So, you know, I'm offering with all my heart a free consultation with you to make you shine again. You are one of my personal missions. I'm looking for you. There is no one in Argentina right now, nobody in Italy right now. I've been there with my family, and you know, we are looking for healers like you. So I want to make you shine. So, you know, I'm open for questions or any free consultation that you want to have to build that unforgettable brand. And thank you so much, Susan, because you have been amazing in this co-creation so far.
Thank you. Thank you, Saul. So what I have to say to all the AMDs out there and all the dentists who are not yet AMDs but want to be is that you deserve to come out of being buried in your office website. You deserve a personal brand where people can really see the why behind your becoming an AMD. I mean, why did you go from a biological dentist, Dr. Jeff, to become an AMD? And what the result is, okay, what empowerment you've gotten. The same thing with Dr. Susan, right? So these are powerful personal stories that should come out. And Saul is the expert in knowing how to bring it out in your personal website. Other general dentists who do the run-of-the-mill cosmetic general dentistry, or I'm not putting them down, but I'm just saying that if you are regular people, then get buried in your office website. But there's a saying that I never forgot. It says, well-behaved women never make history, right? Well, AMDs are making history. And you don't have to be, you don't have to misbehave, but you do need to brand yourself so that you can connect with members out there in your community who are looking for you desperately. And Saul is the bridge. Saul is the catalyst. Saul is going to be your inspiration. So if you want to
You
go.
are my inspiration as well, all of you. All of you. I'm actually co-creating with Dr. Felix and with Dr. Susan to really get to know you, the AMDs, and the passion that you have. I mean, we're all looking for you. Like Argentina, we have, millions of people as well here looking for this kind of holistic approach, right? And the epigenetics. So thank you for inviting me, Dr.
Thank
Felix.
you. Thank you. Hey, Dr. Susan, are you still there?
Cheers.
All right. Would you have any parting advice for all the AMDs, wannabes out there, or people who are thinking, eh, should I do this? Should I not? What's your advice to them?
You're muted, Susan. She's a perfectionist.
Mute. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. It's interesting because I got into dentistry late in life, and so I was very fearful to open up my own practice and take on all this debt and be the leader of a staff and all that kind of thing. So for me to kind of do my own thing in this way and branch out from this comfort zone of like, oh, I've only been in dentistry 10 years and I can't run a whole staff and I can't own a practice. And that was kind of my mindset. But once I started having this passion for this, it was like not even, I didn't even feel like it was a risk. And the more I venture out into, now it's my second year into this, I feel like that's where I'm headed. And I don't think I would have said that a couple years ago. I always thought, oh, I'll never have my own practice. I'll never do my own thing because I got into dentistry too late and I'll never be profitable for me. And I don't want the headache. But the every day that goes by, I think more and more about how can I do this on my own? How can, I create my own environment where it's, the patients that I really love to work with and the staff that I really love to work with, rather than it being about, what the norms of dentistry are. And I still do practice dentistry 4 days a week. So it's, I guess what I'm trying to say is the advice is that there's so much potential and new horizons that, you're no longer bound by the, typical model of dentistry. And that's what's so exciting to me. And that's what I'm so passionate about, that the mouth holds so much more than just drilling and filling and being a tooth doctor. And it becomes your purpose that goes so much deeper. And then it doesn't feel like a risk to do this work.
Wonderful. Well, thank you. And I want everybody to pay attention. I want you to compare the left image here to what she appears on the screen live now. How
Beautiful.
much more alive and beautiful and natural and radiant she is, okay? It doesn't have to do with lighting. It has to do with how she feels inside.
I'm with my dogs. I'm at the beach.
Yeah. Hey, oh, tell them about your story about not being able to walk your dog and to now you can enjoy them.
Actually, this is the perfect path. Yeah, I used to come up here. And then there came a time when I would walk on the stuff and I'd be trying to go back, and it was getting dark, and my hip just was in so much pain. I couldn't walk and I couldn't hold on to the dogs anymore. And I would just sit here for like, I'd say, a good 30 minutes, 45 minutes, and I couldn't move. And I got afraid and I stopped taking this trail because I knew that I couldn't get back to my car. So it's a very slow grade. It's not like very steep or anything. It's a beautiful area, cove. But I really stopped doing the things that I love to do because I just was in too much pain. And now I walk it almost every day and it's not a problem whatsoever.
And
so
what was the difference? And what was the difference?
The difference was being treated, my mouth. My mouth was the difference. It
There
was
it
all
is. Oral
my mouth was an
contribution.
off balance.
Oral contribution to her hip pain, right?
Yeah.
And so
for sure.
Here we have a gorgeous set of teeth, and yet the patient is suffering systemically, right? And so we were able to accomplish 96% improvement. This just goes to show how big the mouth is. And we were able
huge.
To produce this result without opening up spaces, create diastemas. 10 years younger? No, it's more than that. It's not accurate. All right. Well, thank you for your contribution, everyone. We have CJ Koh here, who also is a airway treatment coordinator. Hello, CJ. You still there? Oops. I guess not. Okay. Well, I want to, again, thanks everybody for contributing to the future AMDs by sharing your experience. And you will become an angel in many patients' lives now and all the way to the end of your career. And because you're AMDs, you deserve to be seen. You deserve to be recognized. And therefore, I recommend that you just click this link. Let me copy this. And we'll paste it into the chat box so that other people...
See you on Tuesday, Susan.
Huh?
See you on Tuesday.
Okay, I'm going to paste this into the chat box, and then those of you who are interested could just click on that, paste it into your browser, and connect with Saul. All righty. Thank you, and have a good
Saul's
evening.
Saul's amazing.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Brittany, Dr. Jeff, Saul.
Thank you, everyone. I cannot
Karen,
stop
thank
smiling.
You for coming.